As a society, we are at risk of losing our greatest asset, our young people, to drugs, gangs, violence, and hopelessness. Growing up in poverty, young people are often left alone and confronted with a choice between life and a culture of death. The church in these areas is often the only part of our society offering life. In the Diocese of Little Rock, Arkansas, Jaime Torres has undergone his own life-giving transformation. Jaime promised his life to Jesus and decided to help others by building a transformative ministry for gang members seeking a better life.
I was in a gang for 10 years in California. It was hard for me just to stop using drugs, but I know that there's someone that can help, and his name is Jesus.
The Lord works through the improbable people sometimes more effectively than the people that you would have scripted for the job. He's got the gifts, and well, the Lord is working through him.
Que viva Jesucristo, que viva! Y que viva Jesucristo, que viva!
The problem that we have in this community is from kids from 12 years and up. We have to learn how to talk to them.
Fuerza Transformadora is the main initiative in our diocese regarding gangs. It means transforming force. And the idea is that an encounter with Jesus Christ can really change your life.
So we started using what they call cranca, and then I started getting involved with the wrong people, selling that. That's whenever I felt like, you know, I'm not gonna have any control over myself anymore. I started coming to Fuerza, and it changed my life. I'm happy every day. I mean, I'm alive, God's with me, and having my family, it's a blessing. Also serving in church. Because I remember when I was there, using drugs or drinking, and now they're here because somebody reached out to them.
Like my friends want me to do something I don't want to. This shows me how to deal with that or how to overcome it. My life is Christ-centered instead of self-centered.
They're gonna make us more Catholic. They're gonna make us more inclusive. They're gonna make us a church that is that really is able to go out to the periphery and the margins, like Pope Francis calls us to. That's where Jesus spent his time, and that's where his church needs to be.
In Salinas, California, where the violent crime rate is nearly double that of the U.S. average, a Catholic youth group has taken to the streets to transform their community in response to the violence they experienced in their own lives.
It comes in waves, you know. Sometimes it's very peaceful, sometimes it's very violent. I believe that if we can walk with faith, with a positive attitude, things change.
The peace walks here in the community have been somewhere where we've been going out and walking really in the high-risk places where, you know, gang violence and where, you know, a lot of this violence really and this gang activity is occurring in our community. We go out there and simply make a presence for peace.
In the Diocese of Stockton, California, Jose and Digna Lopez have dedicated their lives to young people. We spoke with two of the young people Jose and Digna have mentored, both of whom have an understanding of how pivotal youth ministry can be.
I was a little involved in gangs, and I got a lot of trouble. I got suspended from school. Either you change, or it's gonna be hard times.
They need to grow up in an environment where they're learning about God, where they're learning about friendships, where they're learning about family. That's the type of stuff that youth needs.
We are a universal church, and that inspires us to support at-risk youth, treat them with compassion, and see the humanity in them, and to share the hope and joy that God's love brings to everyone.